Good morning, class. We are going to study about the political chapter 1, and the topic is power sharing. We had already studied about the power sharing in the last class. And we had taken an example of Belgium, how the Belgium country is located in Europe. It is a small country. It has a population of 1 crore people. It has a ethnic composition which is very complex. There are people like 59% of the population are speaking Flemish region, Dutch language in Flemish region. Next 40% is speaking French in Wallonia region. The Brussels as its capital, out there the people speak French. Although the population is high of Dutch, but speaking is French. So there is a lot of complications. Similarly, we are going to study the story of Sri Lanka. Story of Sri Lanka. Now, same way. Now, Sri Lanka is a part of India. It's close to India. It's a, no doubt, it's a separate country, but it comes into Indian subcontinent. It lies in the south of India. So Sri Lanka is an island nation. It is surrounded by water from all four sides. South of India. And it has a diverse population of about 2 crore people. In this, the major social groups are the Sinhala groups speakers that consist of about 74% people of Sri Lanka speak Sinhala language, and the other are Tamil speakers, and that consists about 18%. So two different language speaking people reside in Sri Lanka. Now the Sri Lankan Tamils, the Sri Lankan Tamil speaking people, the Tamil speaking people of Sri Lanka consist of consist of 13%. And Tamil nation of the country means they are properly residing, they are the born from Tamil Sri Lanka. Tamil nation Tamil natives of the country Sri Lanka Kerala Tamil. Now the rest Indian Tamils means these are the people who went to Sri Lanka in the colonial, say 50, 60, 70 years back. These Britishers has taken them to Sri Lanka for the war. So Indian Tamil consist of say 5% who had come from India. During colonial period, as plantation workers, so these are Indians who went to Sri Lanka. Now what happened is most of these Sinhalas, that is people who were living in Sri Lanka from before, so most of the Sinhala speaking people are Buddhist. So this is the official language of Sri Lanka. So means those people who are Sinhala speakers living the 70% are Buddhist, and this is the official official language. Sinhali is the official language of Sri Lanka. But the people who had gone to Sri Lanka from India do not get these rights. So Buddhism is the official language of Sri Lanka, and like most of them are Sinhala speaking people are Buddhist. Now many who went to India went to Sri Lanka from India, they are like most of the Tamil are either Hindus or Muslim. Hindus or Muslims. Now, other than this, there are about 7% Christians also. Christians who are both Tamils or Sinhala. So again, lot of different type of language speaking people are residing in a country, and they have to make constitution regarding all these people without harming their integrity, their traditions, their culture. So it's very difficult for a country to manage all this, and that's why we are going to study this power sharing. How do these politicians or people who are in politics manage the things that not to harm any of the language speaking people. So name the two subgroups of Tamil in Sri Lanka. And question number two, what is the official religion of Sri Lanka?